G'day. In this video, we're going to be looking at analysing a function that's defined in terms of a power series. In this case, f of x is sigma k x to the k, sum from 1 to infinity. It could be sum from 0 to infinity, of course, but the 0 term will be 0 anyway. So the first thing we want to know is, where does this series converge? For which values of x does this actually make a sensible definition of a function? In the second half of the video, we're going to look at what the function actually is in a closed form. So part A, where does the series converge? Now, you may have a formula for the radius of convergence of a power series. I tend not to use it, I prefer to go straight to the ratio test. But it's important that you remember that a power series will always converge in some interval. Right? It'll converge in from A minus R to A plus R for some A and some R. R is the thing I refer to as the radius of convergence. But I always find these things go much more smoothly if you just forget that rule and just rely on the ratio test, because that's all you're going to do in the end anyway. And you're also going to be testing for absolute convergence, not just convergence. So what you do is you consider the absolute value of the k plus 1 term, in our case, k plus 1 x to the k, divided by k x to the k. Ak plus 1 over ak, if you're thinking in terms of an ordinary series, not just a power series. Well, as is usual, most of these terms cancel off. That should be an x plus 1 there, k plus 1 there, of course. We're going to get, well, k plus 1 over k, that's positive, so I don't need the absolute value signs on that. K plus 1 over k. And I'm going to be left with an x, mod x, in fact, because I've taken absolute values. And what we want to know is, where does this, where is this going to tend to a limit that's less than 1? Well, it's obvious enough that as k goes to infinity, this thing just tends to mod x. And the ratio test tells me that the series will be convergent if this ratio is strictly less than 1. And that's the thing that you want for a power series, because we want some interval of convergence. So f of x, well, we can say f of x converges, slight abuse of terminology, but really the series that converges if mod x is less than 1, i.e. in the open interval minus 1 to 1. Of course, this leaves open the question of what happens at the endpoints. We only consider the endpoints of these intervals of convergence of power series in our higher first year courses. But in this case, it's not difficult to see what happens. When x equals 1, we've got sigma k, 1 plus 2 plus 3, clearly doesn't converge. And when you put x is minus 1, your sum becomes, well, it becomes minus 1 plus 2, minus 3 plus 4. That's not going to converge either. So in fact, this series wouldn't converge at either endpoint. Typically, when you do a convergence at the endpoints, one of them does and one it doesn't, but that's not guaranteed. It's only the sort of questions you tend to get asked. You'd use an alternating series at one end and a not alternating one at the other. All right. So that's where the series converges. The open interval is usually all you're asked for. The next thing is, can we actually find a closed form for this particular function? Can we actually write this function down in something that's more familiar to us? Normally you can't. Normally you write down a power series, it defines a brand new function that doesn't have any other way of being defined. But in this case, you can actually do that. So that's what I'm going to do in the second half of the video. So now we know where this function is well defined. It's defined from minus 1 to 1, that's where the series converges. We want to know, what function is it? Can we find something that's a bit more understandable, something we can actually deal with? Well, in this case we can. The series itself looks a lot like the geometric progression. If the k weren't there down here, it would just be sigma x to the k, which we know is just the geometric series, 1 over 1 minus x. And something similar can be done here. Because what we're going to be relying on is the fact that if you take a power series, you can differentiate term by term. You can treat power series as if they're infinitely long polynomials. As long as you don't divide by zero, more or less everything works. And that's what we're going to do here. So we are given that the sum from k is 0 to infinity, x to the k is 1 over 1 minus x, if mod x less than 1, which is in fact the same as the region on which we know this particular function exists, because that's when the series is convergent, then we can differentiate both sides term by term, and we get here the sum from 0 to infinity. We'll differentiate each x to the k, and you get k x to the k minus 1. Differentiate 1 over 1 minus x, and you get 1 over 1 minus x squared. Well, technically you get minus that times minus 1, but right, the chain rule cancels off. Again, if mod x less than 1, usually a good idea to keep track of where these series are convergent. Well, that's not quite what we wanted, because we've got k times x to the k minus 1 here, and we wanted kx to the k, but we can just multiply through by x. And of course, the k equals 0 term we might as well forget about, because it's just going to be a 0, so we get the sum from k is 1 to infinity, k x to the k is x over 1 minus x all squared, if mod x is less than 1. And that's my closed form.